Rats don't have it easy. You know, there aren't many opportunities for small rodents to shine. Apart from, what, Ratatouille, Stuart Little, and that one Disney mouse who needs no introduction. But in Rattropolis, mice finally get the time under the spotlight they deserve. Right before they're devoured by mutated creatures. Hi guys, welcome to Rattropolis, a new genre-bending game where you're the leader of mice. Let me just say that we had the chance to give this game a go despite it not being free or online, but we like gaming in general, and unique games with roguelike, collectible card game, and tower defense mechanics like this one are right up my alley. Besides, the price tag is low for the hours of enjoyment that it offers, so go check it out. The link's in the video description. Here's our hands-on impressions on this tale of normal mice and mutated crazed mice who seek nothing but to destroy your settlement. Rattropolis is the kind of game that's great for testing your skills and strategy expertise. It starts simple and deceivingly peaceful, before turning into complete chaos and mayhem as your rat city is invaded by monsters left and right. The mix of city builder and card game stands out as you must choose your moves in the nick of an eye, risking everything with every card that you play. The initial card selection seems easy to master, but as you survive wave after wave and climb experience ranks, you unlock more and more cards from a pool of over 500. New cards add more features into the mix, making the initial experience a taxing one, in the positive sense of the word, as you unravel new ways of expanding your city and keeping the creatures at bay. Played from a 2D side-scrolling perspective, the mechanics are extremely simple. You begin by picking your class from a selection of 6 leaders, although you must unlock them as you progress. You have the Merchant, General, Builder, Scientist, Shaman, and Navigator. Each one comes with different advisors and buffs, and the more you play with each one, the more cards and advisors you unlock. Naturally, the buffs give you distinct advantages from extra gold gain to military card improvements, among others. There are 3 different maps right now, Desert, Forest, and Coast, with a few specific events for each one, such as stronger enemies or special rewards. The little mice are too cute, with their little hats and clothes that are unique for each region, and nice water reflection effects. The cards are easily recognizable with their cute artwork, thankfully, I might add, given the hundreds of cards to discover. Your city starts small, but you expand it by building defensive walls at stumps. This allows you to construct more houses and increase your population, but it comes at a cost. You must recruit more soldiers to prevent the onslaught of destructive creatures while balancing it with the other needs of the city, such as gaining more gold from taxes and assorted activities. Moving your soldiers from one side of the city to the other is not advised, because the time that they take to do so is often enough for the creatures to invade the city and reach your base, ending the match. Gold is crucial for the entire match. Each 5 seconds, you earn a specific amount of gold depending on your city development. Playing your cards right, literally, will allow you to earn plenty of gold. But in truth, you're going to need it, because the road ahead gets more challenging and expensive as you survive wave after wave, up to a limit of 30 waves per match. Occasionally, you'll see random events popping up that require your intervention, such as one where you must choose to give a proper burial to the dead, offer condolences to their families, or ominously say that they should be paying death taxes. Your choice may lead to a reward, a penalty, or both in some cases. There are a ton of these events, apparently more than 100 at the time. Now and then, a merchant arrives in town with a nice selection of cards that you can purchase, if you have the gold to do so. One thing I've noticed is that in Rattropolis, your most valuable currency isn't gold. Neither is the valuable treasure chest with cards that each destroyed wave leaves behind. Your best ally is time, and you must manage it perfectly so that you don't feel overwhelmed by the incoming wave. This is a challenging and addictive game that can become frustrating if you don't learn from your mistakes and anticipate what it's going to throw at you next. Be quick to judge and react accordingly to prevent the creatures from crashing into your city. Rattropolis is a nice game that successfully blends several genres into one. Personally, I've enjoyed my time with it and will surely keep coming back for more to unlock new cards and advisors and compare my position in the leaderboard to the rest of the leaders of mice. Check it out. The Steam link is in the description. And have fun. Wow.
Ha ha ha!